My name is Liz Burke, and I will serve as your lector this morning. A warm welcome is extended to any visitors who join us today. Please note, face masks are required to be worn during Mass at St. John's, except in the case of a medical exemption. We thank you for your cooperation in following the guidelines and in helping to make everyone feel safe and welcome in Mass. Please also note, baskets will now be passed during the offertory. Today we celebrate the sixth Sunday of Easter. Our celebrant for today's Mass will be our pastor, Father Richard Cannon. The intention for which we have been asked to pray for this Mass is for you, the parishioners of St. John's. Please rise and join in the opening hymn, Love Divine, All Love Is.
Thank you. days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, that what we live in remembrance may always hold to in what we do. While Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him and, falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God. And Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. To keep my commandment, remain in my love. As I have kept my Father's commandment, remain in his love. I've taught you this so that my joy may be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends, if you do what I command you. No longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I've called you friends, and have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It's not you who chose me, it was I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain. So whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Miracle performed at the intercession of Our Lady.
she's still quite willing and very eager to make intercession for us. Also at Cana was recorded Our Lady's last words spoken in sacred scripture. Do whatever he tells you. Now, beautiful words from a loving, caring mother who cares about us and our salvation when it comes to her son. Do whatever he tells you. When our Lord is on the cross, he endured so much suffering and seemed as if he had nothing more to give. Our Lord gave us his mother. He turned to the beloved disciple, St. John, an icon of all believers throughout all history. He turned to John, behold thy mother. And the sacred scripture says, and he took her into his home at that hour. And that's why every church, in every Catholic chapel, in just about every Catholic home, there's always an image of our Blessed Mother Mary, be it a painting, a statue, or whatever. Because we too take Mary into our home. And also our Lord turns to our Blessed Mother Mary and says, a woman, behold your son. And our Blessed Mother Mary is given a duty by our king, her king too, to be the mother of all of us. And it's a duty, and it's an undertaking. She relishes. She loves to be a mother. You know, this mystics, this is not sacred scripture. This mystics in the church, you know, they have recorded, you know, some just magnificent experiences with our Blessed Mother Mary. And sometimes they're asked, what is it like with our Blessed Mother? I mean, can you really sense her love? And then one of the mystics would say, well, take the love of the best mother you can possibly think of and multiply that times 1,000 times, you still do not get the love that Mary has for each one of us. Let us not hesitate to turn to our Blessed Mother in our needs. She's waiting for us. You know, when I grew up in a town, I grew up in Millis, not too far away, in our kitchen growing up, was a plastic statue of our Blessed Mother Mary. It's always in the kitchen. It was not expensive. It was kind of worn, but it was always there. You just stop and you just, you know, the images, of sacred images in houses really can generate questions for children. And you just wonder how many unspoken impressions do statues and religious images create upon our young people. But anyway, we had that statue when I was a young kid, and I asked my mother, now what's that statue all about? And she told me, well, that's a statue of our Blessed Mother Mary, which I know. She told me the story. My parents got married, both from Newton Corner, they're from Our Ladies of Newton, and they got married on September 11, 1954. And for some of you who may remember, very few I'm sure, but there was a hurricane that day, Hurricane Edna. It's the day before you have all these early warnings, they just didn't exist. But anyway, that morning, my mother's wedding, she's out the clothesline. It's one of those old fashioned clotheslines. It was metal, metallic, it had four arms to it, bent over. And in the middle was a post. And on the top of that post, she placed that statue, the classic statue of our Blessed Mother Mary. And she always took it out with her when she did the clothes. Anyway, because of the day, she's worried about the weather, it was almost starting to get overcast, she forgot to take that statue in. So anyway, the day goes on, she gets married, the hurricane comes, she's still having the wedding reception, all that sort of thing, and then the old Philomathia Club at Boston College. Anyway, she forgets about that statue. Her mother discovers it later on. She comes back from the honeymoon, she's thrilled that that statue was there. Her mother said, it survived, it was left out overnight, it survived this hurricane that uprooted trees, roofs off houses and buildings, but this statue stood. So my Blessed Mother, so that's the story between that plastic statue that's in our kitchen and still was in my mother's kitchen. What kind of nice feeling growing up, knowing the special presence of Papa's and Mother in the home. And I'm sure your parents did what they could have you know the special presence of our Lord and our Lady at home. You know, yesterday, Friday was the first Friday of the month. We got in the Sacred Heart of our Lord, that beautiful image of the Sacred Heart, way up there, a heart encompassed with thorns, burning with love. What's that devotion all about? Almighty God, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ loves us so much. And we see his heart, he wants us to open up our hearts. We can pour his love into our hearts. That's what the devotion is all about, really. That heart, that Sacred Heart of our Lord, first started to beat in the womb of Mary. This week we celebrate the anniversary of Our Lady of Fatima. Request to pray that rosary and to honor the Immaculate Heart to request her son. We do the best to do that. You know, I really pray that rosary. And I can honestly tell you, if it wasn't for that rosary, the influence of the Blessed Mother in my life, I would not be standing here before you as a priest. The month of May reminds us we ought to love our Blessed Mother Mary very much.
Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
Please be seated, and the first time I was here, and then our ushers take up our collection. And also at the auditorium, there's an Eucharistic minister out there. We invite that Eucharistic minister to come forward at communion time.
Thank you.
Never cease to gather your people to yourself, and the rising of the sun will set, your sacrifice will be offered to my name. If, O Lord, we humbly implore you with the same spirit, graciously make holy these gifts, we acknowledge the consecration, and become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is command, we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving you thanks. He said the blessing, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body to be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and gave you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples. Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, but of the new and eternal covenant. We put out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. History. Listen graciously to pray for this family and summon before you. Your compassion and merciful Father, gather yourself all your children scattered among the world. Wide apart our brothers and sisters who are pleasing to you with their passing from the sun. Give kind and to your kingdom, and we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, and from the stone of the world, all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and peace in our days, and for the help of your mercy. And always be free from sin and safe from all distress. With the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. If not upon the sins, but upon the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity, accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to the Son, peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed be those who call the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to share in my room, but a sacred word of my soul shall be. Thank you. for your prayers for Catherine Sullivan when this Mass is offered. And also, just a note, this coming Tuesday, having a holy hour for the sanctity of life from 7, beginning at 7 o'clock, below our chapel. And also, please continue to keep our young people in our prayers. 10 o'clock Mass, we have our First Communion and the Maiden Session. And this coming Thursday is Ascension Thursday, a holy day of obligation, and the Vigil Mass.